Now blast away the debris.
The ceiling appears stable. We should now be able to use turbo lift 2, Captain.
Excellent.
This door leads to turbo lift 2. One of the many battered cores. The support beam appears to have stabilized the ceiling.
I certainly hope so, because we're going to go this way. Okay, so I guess now we can get to these other areas. Transporter room.
Mm-hmm. This corridor leads to the transporter room. A large piece of equipment has fallen through the ceiling. The area looks extremely unstable. Fortunately, the entry to the transporter room is near.
It is, which I guess is this.
This door leads to James T. Kirk.
No kidding.
Mr. Spock. Ensign Keyes.
They're not doing anything.
Leonard McCoy.
They don't feel anything at this point. Oh, there's another dead body.
This man is dead. A large piece of equipment is
What's this?
This is a length of heavy-duty insulated power cable.
You get that?
You pick up a length of cable.
Okay. So now we have two cables.
This is a length of heavy-duty insulated power cable.
Can I connect the cables? Nope. This is green gunk.
This corridor leads...
Nothing.
This corridor leads... This corridor leads to...
I do not see the need for conversation, Captain. Humans have an irrational enjoyment of endless discourse.
It does get better than this, doesn't it, Captain?
No idea, Ensign.
I'd like to meet the people responsible for this and give them a piece of my mind.
You said that before.
I haven't seen anything this bad since I was aboard the Farragut. And this vampire cloud...
This vampire cloud...
There's nothing more I can do.
Nothing to report, Captain. It appears to be a section from a coolant exhaust port. I would not recommend too close of an inspection, Captain. The floor could collapse from our added weight. Nothing to report. Nothing to report, Captain.
All right, let's go in here. More destroyed crap.
The transporter room appears to have escaped serious damage. These sliders activate the transporter system.
They sure do.
This is the transporter chamber. The pads do not seem to be damaged. These are the power conduits for the transporter system. The transporter room appears to have escaped serious damage. Kirk is extremely worried. A resolute Mr. Spock.
Worried and resolute?
Dr. McCoy avoids the glances of his crewmates. Keyes is eager to perform his duties.
Don't be too eager.
This room's in pretty good condition compared to the rest of the ship.
The transporter pads seem intact, Captain.
That's exactly what the narrator lady said.
Oh, great. My favorite place in the ship. Wouldn't you know it would be in the best shape.
I have a bad feeling about this place.
Nothing to report, Captain. Surprisingly, the transporter controls have escaped damage.
What about over here?
Nothing to report, Captain.
What, down here?
Nothing to report.
Okay, fine.
Spock, please check out the transporter.
Nothing to report, Captain.
The impulse engines are not generating any power for this system.
He looks this way and that. Nope, don't see any power around here. Let's connect wires.
Nothing happens.
How about the other wire?
Nothing happens.
How about a laser saw?
Nothing happens.
How about an empty hypodermic
Nothing
needle?
Nothing happens.
What about a hacksaw
Nothing
thing?
Nothing happens.
Okay.
The transporter room. The transporter room. The transporter room. The transporter room.
Spock?
I failed to see the...
He looks at you with a puzzled...
Take a look at this again.
These are the power con...
Power conduits. So you think that maybe...
Nothing happens.
Okay, so maybe we need to go... to engineering. Can we go to engineering? Yes. And get
Captain,
the engines going.
I'm picking up a functioning energy source in the immediate vicinity.
Good.
Oop. This corridor leads to the Republic's engineering section. This door leads to main engineering. These ladders are used when turbo lifts are unavailable. Unfortunately, it is blocked by debris and a small smoldering fire. This corridor leads... A look of terror is still etched on the face of this crewman.
Yeah, that's horrible.
This corridor leads to the Republic's engineer...
What is this?
A rather large pile of debris.
Oh, thank you for answering that. He's dead, Jim.
This person's dead, Jim.
Nothing to report, Cap.
Nothing at all to report.
Nothing to report,
all right,
Captain.
Let's go through the doors then. Hello. We didn't talk to anybody out there or something, did we? Let's look through the debris anyway now. Take debris.
You fail to obtain anything. A sad but determined James T. Kirk.
Yeah, we forgot.
A resolute Mr. Spock. Ensign Keege, learning that Starfleet isn't always very pleasant. Dr. McCoy avoids the glances of his crewmates.
We must complete our mission, gentlemen.
This corridor seems to have been particularly damaged. There have been hull breaches on the deck below.
I will monitor the situation, Mr. Spock. I can use the distraction. Is there a question, Captain?
I'm just wondering if it's adequately distracting you.
I can't say that I'm very talkative right now.
All right, let's go into the next room.
This reminds me of a poem I read when I was a child. I am Ozymandias, King of Kings. Look upon my works, ye mighty, and despair.
You have good reason to despair here, Jim. Remind me to compliment Mr. Scott on the efficiency of his engineering section.
Given that Mr. Scott has received a Starfleet citation on 5 occasions for efficiency, I do not see the logic in your suggestion, Doctor.
This is actually the best place, actually.
There has been a 0.0003 degradation in hull integrity in the last hour. There should be no danger, Captain.
Tragic, Captain. This is one of the greatest disasters in Starfleet history.
Huh. Just wait until Wolf 359. We got stuff.
This is a junction box used for temporary rerouting of engineering circuits.
The whole thing?
This is a junction box. This was the engineering section of the USS Republic.
Technically, it still is. Not for long, but...
This was the engineering section of the... These are the controls to the Republic's impulse engines. This is the fusion mixture regulator for the Republic's impulse engines. This is the fusion mixture These are the impulse engines. This was the engineering section of the... This was the engineering... This was the engineering... This was the engineering...
Can we get any of this stuff?
This was the engineering sec...
Engineering sex? What? This place is pretty okay. There's no one dead in here. There's no sparks flying out.
Nothing to report, Captain. This is an engineering circuit junction box. It is used for temporary rerouting of power. Without using one of these devices set to the proper impedance, an overload can occur.
Hmm. Oh, wait. Is that a dead... That's a dead person.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Never mind what I said. I just saw that arm. It kind of blended in with all the other red here.
Captain, this is the fusion mixture regulator for the impulse engines. There is currently no power running to it. The impulse engines are intact, Captain. We could use the fusion reactors from the impulse engines to restore power, but the lines have been severed to the power regulator.
Can we reroute the power lines?
We should be able to, Captain, if we can find a suitable supply of power cable.
Captain.
We will need to route the power through a junction box so we can set an impedance level. A direct connection to the regulator would cause an overload.
And this is a junction box, correct?
This is a junction box.
Okay.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Maybe Spock needs to do it. Let's torture Bones some more.
There's nothing more I can do.
Help him, dammit! What good are you?
This was the engineering...
It is illogical to use this machine before we have something connected to it.
I'm trying to connect stuff to it. It won't let me.
Nothing happens.
Connect, connect.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Damn you.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Well, maybe we have to connect it here first. There we go. Oh, you're gonna do it together.
You connect a length of cable between the regulator circuits and the junction box.
He's a good boy. Good boys. Whoop.
There has been a point...
You get no response.
I'm not trying to talk to that. I mean, technically, I was, but...
This is a length of heavy-duty insulated power cable.
Okay, so I'm guessing we attach the other cable here in unison, like so.
You connect a length of cable between the impulse engine and the junction box.
Okay. Spock, you want to do the honors?
Please select an impedance.
Spock?
Captain, the wrong setting on this particular device may cause the fusion reactors to melt down. We will have to do some research to determine the correct setting.
Hmm. How do we research?
I fail to see the logic in that action, Captain, this is the fusion mixture regulator for the impulse engines.
Well, where are we gonna...
This is a junction box.
Well, where are we gonna find that out, then? Do I go up here?
This is a standard storage closet.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Didn't notice that. Everything's so red.
The closet opens, revealing a library of engineering technical journals.
Research!
This is a canister of high-grade multipurpose oil, very useful for lubricating machinery.
Hmm.
This is a library of engineering technical journals.
These journals may prove useful in our attempt to re-establish power. A functioning computer terminal will allow us to examine them.
Okay, I guess maybe this computer terminal?
The oil canister is bolted to the hull and can't be taken.
We need oil.
The hypo is now filled with multipurpose oil.
Alright, we got oil. I don't know what caused me to think of that, but there you go.
The hypo is now filled. You take the engineering technical journals.
Hey, hey.
This is a set of engineering technical journals.
That it is. Journals.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Okay, I guess we need a different...
Nothing happens.
Computer terminal? Let's go seek that out. Over yonder, other destroyed parts of the ship. Yeah, this thing bothers me. Seems weird that it's there. We blew away other debris.
Oh my God, Jim, is that what I think it is?
No idea.
Yes, Doctor. It is a portable fusion power pack.
A few centimeters lower with that phaser and half the section would be history, not to mention us.
Actually, Doctor, 3.2 centimeters. And based on our proximity to the explosion and the angle of the beam.
Thank you, Spock. I think we get the point.
Either way, we were lucky.
This is the most powerful portable energy storage device ever developed by man. It is used to provide temporary power to small systems when main or auxiliary power is unavailable.
Cool. I'm surprised you couldn't see it under there.
A standard portable fusion power pack. It is fully functional, Captain.
Let's hope it is fully gettable as well.
You pick up the portable fusion power pack.
Looks too big to be portable, doesn't it? Okay, we got all kinds of stuff.
A portable fusion pack.
Alright. I don't suppose we can use these technical journals on any of these things.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Alright, let's be gone. And be gone.
Turbo lift access is blocked by...
Transporter room. I don't think this is the kind of computer terminal they're talking about, but since we're here...
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. Sick bay? Unless we're supposed to go to the bridge with that thing.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Read these for me.
Nothing happens.
She's dead, Jim. You know what? With that syringe, it was weird. In the auxiliary section, he actually went up to... He wouldn't have done that if there wasn't a reason. He actually went up and put the syringe in here, so I wonder... Right, if we oil this, it won't be so tightly jammed. I only got the idea because I thought it was weird how we had an option to use a syringe on this stuff.
The oil seeps into and loosens the debris.
Aha! I think I'm actually just having some lucky luck over here.
The gears are completely cleared of debris.
Okay. Now do stuff?
The panel is open.
Wasn't it already open?
The panel is open.
Okay, so I'm just opening it and opening it over and over again. Somehow.
The gears are moving freely and are completely operative.
If I go here, will I close the panel?
The panel is open.
No, here.
The panel is open.
Okay. Hopefully I didn't wreck anything.
The gears are moving.
How do I close the panel?
The panel is open.
I know. Power pack?
Nothing happens.
It already has power. It's operational. So how do we open... Can I just go like this? Oh, good. Okay. All right. Oh, and possibly computer terminals we can use. Yay.
This is the Republic's auxiliary control room. It appears to be in better shape than the main bridge.
Yeah, no kidding.
The auxiliary control room view screen is still operating. It is displaying a view of empty space. This is a standard input-output slot for record decks.
Oh, cool.
This is a standard input.
Oh, the whole thing.
This is the Republic.
I thought they were talking about this specifically.
This is the Republic. Damage from the battle has disabled the ship's main computer.
Oh, brother.
This is the Republic. You look but see nothing of note.
Better than this is the Republic's.
This is the impulse power allocation control. Indicators currently show no power output from the impulse engines.
Yeah, I didn't use that stuff yet.
This is the Republic's...
Wire?
This is the Republic's... This is the Republic's...
Anyone dead here? What is this thing?
These are Federation standard record decks.
Take.
You take the record decks.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Record decks.
These are Federation.
Captain's log. Stardate 6087.6. The Republic is currently approaching the Vardane system. Sensors have detected unusual energy fluctuations near one of the Vardanian moons. Starfleet has ordered us to investigate.
Vardane. Anything else?
Captain's log, Stardate 6087.8. We are under attack by two unidentified ships. I don't know how they could have approached undetected.
Two.
They must have some kind of cloaking device, although there are no reports of Romulans in this sector.
A lassie, maybe? Anything else?
Captain, Stardate 6088.1. We have successfully driven off our assailants. Major damage has been sustained by our warp engines. Communications has reported that USS Enterprise is in sector. I requested Mr. Scott's assistance in repairing damage to the Republic. With luck, we will be fully operational in a couple of days.